music to my ears. Get settled in. Your Rasta's in town. I don't touch meat. You couldn't get me to touch meat. Stuffed fish disgust me. I'll eat things that are from the ground. Liberty, way of life, living off the land. And that's what you gotta make it. Everything is a way of life. So good. These are the stuff that I soak out. Like I got my black eyed peas. There's my kidneys. I got my yellow split peas. This is gold, chickpeas. Can't go wrong with those. I live off of chickpeas. I can eat chickpeas 7 days out of the week. Well, what else do we have in the kitchen? Let's see. Canned chickpeas, black beans, white kidney beans, black eyed peas. And here's some of my meat alternatives. Meatless chicken. This is smoky chipotle, ginger lime. That's it, little tiny kitchen, not much to it. Fridge is a mess on the inside, so I'm not even gonna show it to you. I love bodybuilding because it gives me more drive, it gives me more focus. Super passionate about it. It's a me against me mentality, and it's like I can never beat myself, I can only make myself better.
Come on. Ain't stopping me now.
Your body wants to give up, but your mind will take you somewhere the body never wants to go. To me, it's a natural high, and nothing beats it. The endorphins are amazing. It's just the feeling that you get, you just want to get back at it and see how much you could push yourself the next day, and that's why I love bodybuilding. People say I'm an extremist, but I don't feel it's being an extremist. I feel people who are meat eaters are extremists. If you have to go murder your food, and in that sense, to me, that's an extremist. To me, I find my way of living is very basic. All my stuff comes from the ground. It's like, how extreme is that? Compared to somebody who has to go out to, say, kill their food or go to the supermarket and get that from whatever manufacturer it is. There's nothing more extreme than if you were to sit down and watch videos about how they slaughter and kill animals, because the torture that they put the animals through is unreal. We're killing our world. And if you realize how much water and how much food it takes to produce that animal to get it to the supermarket, we're really killing our world compared to somebody who, say, is a vegan. And it's a win-win. You're healthier, everybody gets to live, everybody's cruelty-free, and the main thing is everybody's respected. people say, oh, it's a lot of asparagus. How can you eat it all in a week? Trust me, it'll be gone. On a regular meal, I'll probably take in 8 to 10 of these. So that's why I'd rather have more than enough asparagus than not enough, because if I run out, I'll go crazy. I'm 1 week away from my show in Montreal, Musclemania, natural bodybuilding. I'm gonna be huge compared to what I was in May, and I'm actually going to be lighter weight. So it's all about body composition and knowing how to train your body, how to fuel your body right, because if you're not fueling your body right, you're not gonna get the gains that you're looking to get. Posing means everything, because you can have the best physique on stage, but if you can't display your body right, you're not gonna win. It's almost like my posing coach explained the other night to me. He's like, how are you gonna have a pretty picture, but put in a dirty frame? You want to display your artwork, you want to display it in a nice frame. So you gotta get posing down or it means nothing. Your body is a temple, so you gotta treat it like a temple. And what you do today is gonna affect how your body is tomorrow or 10 years down the road. I'm a vegan for life. There's no turning back for me.
I'm feeling positive vibes. I think good things are gonna happen today. My main thing is I wanna show the meat eater competitors that a vegan can still hold his weight on the stage with meat eaters. If not, do even better.